This is how to remove a balloon from the sky in Final Cut Pro. It's a very simple technique to remove an object from a still image by duplicating the image, and then masking the top image and moving the bottom image so that only the sky is seen through the mask. It then appears that the object has been removed from the sky, but it's a whole different ballgame with video where the object moves, but the mask stays still. Even Final Cut Pro's new object tracker doesn't track masks. And here's a plea to Apple, please add masks to the object tracker. In next week's tutorial, I'll show you how to remove an object from a moving image in video. So please like and subscribe and press the bell and press all in the bell to make sure that you're notified about next week's tutorial. I'll show you in this video how to do it with a still image. Place the cursor in the image in the browser. Press Option plus F. This creates a freeze frame in the timeline as a connected clip. Right-click on the freeze frame in the timeline and select Overwrite to Primary Storyline. While it's selected in the timeline, hold the Option key and drag a copy below. You could use a draw mask, as you'll see in next week's tutorial, but for this instance, a shape mask is simpler. Position the shape over the small balloon. Make sure the transform tool is turned off. You won't see the mask while the transform is active. The green dots resize the mask and the white dot reshapes from square to round. The inner red line changes the scale of the whole mask. The other red line, that's the outer one, changes the feather, which is a fade out at the edge, and you'll see the value of this in a minute. These actions can be mirrored in the inspector. To be able to remove the balloon, and you'll need the invert mask tick. You won't see any changes at the moment because the copied clip is below. I'll hide that for the moment by pressing the V key while the lower image is selected. This hides that image from view and it goes dark grey in the timeline. Now you can see black where the balloon was. You've effectively cut out the balloon and you're seeing through a hole in the top image. Now select the top image again and untick the invert mask. And now you're only seeing the balloon. The rest of the image is masked. And a warning for new users. You need to be sure which image is selected, that yellow outline at the timeline, before you make changes in the inspector. This is something that you'll get used to over time. As a beginner, you'll forget to switch selections and wonder why you can't see an option in the inspector. It's just a matter of practice, and we've all done it. To hide the balloon, you need to make sure the bottom image is selected. Right-click in the viewer and select Transform. Now drag the viewer until you have the best matching sky, and most likely it won't be perfect. And this is where feather in the top image is important. Make sure the top image is selected and Transform is turned off. Now you'll see the mask again. Either in the inspector or directly in the viewer, increase the amount of feather. And you'll need to be careful about exposing that balloon again. Maybe select a different part of the sky, and it's all a matter of trial and error. It's no doubt that Final Cut can do a lot, but you do need to know how to use it. I'll help you make the most of your time and show you face to face how to get the most out of the application. In next week's tutorial, I'll show you how to do this with an image that moves. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and more importantly, press the bell when it shows all to be advised when next Sunday's video is published.